Hi, I'm Susie Nanny. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Family Medicine and Community Health here at the Medical School at the University of Minnesota. I'm an active member of the program in Health Disparities Research. Project Break is funded by the stimulus funds, and we just completed our two-year study in August of 2011. The purpose of Project Break was to improve access to the school breakfast program. We did this by working with four area high schools to bring the serving line out to the atrium area, so it greeted students when they first came in the morning, and to allow eating in the hallway in classrooms, and an active promotion marketing campaign to make eating the school breakfast cool. The idea from Project Break came from schools who had actually requested help with improving participation in their school meal programs and after-school snack programs. We've long known the benefits of eating breakfast across the lifespan, that breakfast eaters tend to weigh less and have healthier diets. In particular, a benefit for youth are breakfast eaters among youth perform better academically and have fewer absences from schools. The results of Project Break, our research findings were quite compelling. First and foremost, we saw significant improvements in school breakfast participation for Project Break schools compared to the other two schools. Significantly so for those students who are most likely to skip breakfast, and that's girls, and those students who are eligible for free or reduced school meals. School food service made an interesting observation also. Their perception was that because of moving the cafeteria line out to the atrium area, they felt that there was less stigma associated with eating the school breakfast program. Students, and these are high school students, they were excited to have an adult greet them first thing in the morning. These students developed the breakfast week and participated in the taste testings and participated in the video productions that accompanied the promotional activities. So students participated not only in breakfast eating, but in creating the awareness in a campaign and really guiding the process. So based off of the knowledge that we learned from Project Break, our recommendations to other schools or other researchers is to improve access. In addition to that is to adopting policies that allow students to eat in the hallway and to eat in the classroom. Thirdly is to include students in the process.